hip hop with a little sports talk. Dark Side Sports Radio, Saturday, 6 to 8 p.m. Deep Ellum on air.
Yes, Master.
Rise.
At you live, Dark Side Sports Radio with JD.
JD Leo the Lion on the mic with my boy Marvino the True.
Leo, your boy Marvino the True.
Pewopolis is not with us, but we got the greatest sleeper of all time, Sleeping Bag Sid.
Your boy Bags in the house. What's going on?
Now we got Jedi, Boss Man, Kung Fu, Neighborhood Avenger, Jansen on the wheels of
Slash Secret Service.
Slash the latest waiver at the president, which we will get into a little later on into the shizzle. Right about now, we want to thank all of our Dark Side Elite for listening. We love y'all to death, babies. I'm trying to tell you, we love you to death. Go come to all of y'all houses and give all y'all hugs and daps. Love you to death, yo. The people overseas, Slovakia, Slovenia. We got Florida. We got some people from Florida over there listening now. Young Ash and all of that.
Yeah.
And we just keep accumulating fans, man. And that's just because we love y'all to death. Thank y'all for listening, babies.
Make sure you get one of them Young Ash songs on tonight, Jedi.
And yo, can't forget our sponsors, man. We still got the Glass House up in the house.
Yeah, buddy.
Oh yeah.
Yes, already, sir. Glass yeah. House. Still
and the people we donate to, who was it, Jedi?
Hire Heroes.
Yeah, HireHeroes.org. Shout out to them.
HireHeroes.org, most definitely.
HireAHero.org.
What'd I say right there?
Hires Heroes.
Yo, don't listen to me, players. Listen to the other people telling you about the HireAHeroes.org. Yo, we got Cowboy Draft Talk and other teams we're going to talk about tonight in the NFL. Little drafts. Got a whole lot of NBA talk. We got some baseball talk for you. News you can use. Damn it, I'm from the old school. And come on, players. So come on, players. We love you to death. We about to do this thing. Now, the Cowboys draft, okay? I think this was a bad draft, man. This kind of reminded me of like back in the day when you went in and stood in the real long line for the government cheese. You know what I'm saying? It seems like the Cowboys were standing in this long line for this very good government cheese. And we got up to the front of the line.
It was the same old government cheese.
We got a miniature can of Cheese Whiz.
For real.
You know what I'm saying? We didn't even get like the full box of them.
Right.
That's what we got out this draft right
now. They done changed it. They give you the little Cheese Whiz thing.
That's what we got because, okay, the talk of the draft is the number 18 spot that we had. We should have held on to.
Yeah, we traded to the 49ers.
Traded it to the 49ers. Ended up fleecing the hell out of us. We got the 49ers 31st pick.
Man, them 49ers cleaned up in the draft, man.
We also got their 74th pick, I believe. Their 31st and 74th pick. Now, with the 31st pick, we picked a center, Travis Frederick.
Right.
Now, they think this guy's going to be a good center. You know what I'm saying? And the thing about this draft is we may have gotten some solid players.
Yeah, we did. I think we did.
It's some people that's kind of down on the tight end, Gavin Escobar. Okay, because they say he can't really block.
Yeah, but they say he can catch everything that comes his way.
Yeah, and the thing about it is we had that in Hannah already. That's what we drafted last year, was a pass catching tight end. So it's kind of questionable as to why the Cowboys would go that way. But the biggest thing about this draft, man, that's disappointing to the fans is at 18, we wanted to get this defensive tackle, Floyd. Floyd was very good defensive tackle. As a matter of fact, they said he can play all positions on the defensive line, besides him just being a damn good player. So we could have got him at 18 and stayed at 47 and still got Travis Frederick at 47, which, you know, makes the Cowboys basically look like they didn't know what in the hell they were doing.
Well, yeah. You know, keep in mind, when it's live and it's going, I mean, you don't really know how it's going to go. Even Jerry Jones and his crew, you know, they don't know who's going to get picked next, and then all you can do is hope.
Yeah, but at the same time, when you got Jerry Jones as your GM, it's sad to say.
Yeah.
That's why we in the predicament we in.
Yeah, that's because we in the predicament we in right now.
Yeah, and
there,
Jerry
man.
Jones showing up was front and center in the war room.
We got a cornerback, B.W. Webb, in the fourth round.
Man, my bad. We should have brought up the video, the audio with Jerry Jones. They got audio of Jerry Jones calling.
Oh, yeah, with his family. They was pretty excited when he got drafted. They say this guy should be able to step in and take.
Who did he call?
He called B.W. Webb.
You don't have to work for me, but I'm going to pay you a lot of money.
Well,
we needed a player on each position.
Yeah.
So it's like we really couldn't go wrong. I know it was positions we needed more than others, maybe, you know, but, you know.
What do you think about Jerry Jones making the statement of we didn't take the dynamic defensive tackle Floyd because we were good on defensive line? What do you think about us being good on defensive line? Because I don't particularly think so. Spears is gone, you know, to Baltimore. You got Ratliff, who's has these injury problems. You don't know if he's going to play the full 16 games. The guy that was supposed to be the fill-in and eventually replace Ratliff, Brent Jones, remember, he got in the car wreck. Now he's gone because he's most likely going to be in jail. So what do you think about that statement of, you know, Jerry saying, well, you know what, we don't need defensive tackles. We good right there.
Well, I don't know as far as, you know, we good kind of the statement, you know. But I think our offensive line needed more help than our defensive line is what he was thinking, I guess.
Isn't it disappointing to know, though, that you could have had a dynamic defensive tackle and you still could have got the guy at 31, where you could have got him at 47 that you got at 31.
Well, in hindsight, you know, now we can see that, you know, but at the time when it was live, you know, they didn't know if they was going to be able to get him, so they felt like they did what was best for the team.
Cowboys drafted a which most consider to be a project safety in J.J. Wilcox. Said he only played safety 1 year, and he also played, he was like a halfway wide receiver. He's also a punt returner, and they say he also, you know, played a lot of special teams. They say he will be one of the best special teamers that we have once he joins the team, but they're looking for him to be able to take somebody's spot in the, you know, at the safety position. What do you think about the Cowboys drafting these developmental type guys? And it says he's very athletic as well. But what do you think about Cowboys drafting these developmental type guys when they really haven't shown that they know how to develop talent over the years?
Well, in this draft, it was so slim pickings. You know, pretty much every player in this draft was pretty much developmental, you know. Everybody. I mean, even Manti Te'o, you know, everybody's been talking about him, but he's even to some point still needs some tweaking, you know. So maybe they see something in him that they can work with, you know.
But at the same time, the players that we already had, they haven't even worked with those.
Yeah, well, we got this first year with this defensive coordinator and, you know, and this offensive coordinator thing that, you know, we're going to be doing. So we got to see how it's going to go.
Jerry Jones said that they got three guys that were rated top five on their draft board. And he was very animated about that. And
you say he was animated?
Yeah, that they got three because, okay, you know, we the fans in some of the draft the major draft people and scouts just feel like we could have gotten more for the you know, for what we had. You know what I mean? They basically were not prepared for the draft. Is why we ended up with one player in the first two, you know what I'm saying? First round instead of two players, you know, in the first two. Instead of a guy that really most people project to be a star. Why are you passing up on a star?
Yeah.
Man, at the end of the day, it really points to Jerry Jones not knowing what in the hell he's doing, man. And it all comes back to the GM. Jerry always says that, well, we defer to the scouts. If that's the case, you need to get rid of your scouts, man.
Know what I'm saying? It didn't seem like he was, you know, looking at the footage of the war room. It didn't look like he was doing it on his own, you know. It seemed like Steven, you know, his son that, you know, had a lot to say something. I seen Jason Garrett sitting right there. I don't know. I didn't really see him saying much, but.
Before I get to this little receiver, Terrence Williams, we got, let me try to stay on this tight end real quick, Escobar. We got Gavin Escobar, okay, which was a highly questionable draft pick. And the coach said, Jason Garrett, by the way, said, we got this guy because really it's all about formations and personnel, you know. And his pass catching is going to allow us to even open up running lanes for the running game. And that statement was so ridiculous to me because we don't run the football.
Exactly. Yeah, well,
I mean, what kind of sense does that make to get a tight end, you know what I mean? And it's not a blocking tight end, by the way, which and see, that should really tell you something, that it's not a blocking tight end because we want to pass the ball, right?
Yeah.
So maybe they tried to get a non-blocking tight end on purpose, man. I mean, everybody says your tight end has to catch and he has to be able to block.
Yep.
I don't know how much emphasis the Cowboys put on both of those things for a tight end, man. We all know Jason Witten can do it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But we also know that for the most part, Jason Garrett wants to throw the damn football, man. So for him to make that statement and say it's all about formations and, well, it's going to open up the running game, that's ridiculous because we don't even run the football.
Yeah, we definitely hadn't seen it yet. So, you know, like I said, with this new offensive coordinator thing they got going on, maybe we'll see more running this year.
We got Terrence Williams in the third round, who is a receiver from Baylor. They say this guy should be able to step right in and be the third receiver, which is great. Have you ever seen this guy play from Baylor?
No, I haven't.
I've heard a lot about him, though. They say he is he should be able to step right in as a slot receiver and says he has tremendous speed.
Well, I know if DeMarco Murray get hurt again this year, we're going to see him.
It was just a bad draft. That's just the bottom line.
I wouldn't call it a bad draft.
Yeah, you can never say it's a bad draft until
we see something. You
know, until years on down right, the line. Right. You can't, the only thing we can say, I guess, is it's disappointing as far as a fan's aspect when you think about the history of the Dallas Cowboys and how, man, really the last 17 years, every year, the last 17 years, except for those years we had Bill Parcells, we've been horrible. We've been a horrible drafting football team. So it's just hard to, you know, take this draft and say, okay, these guys are going to pan out, because they haven't, as long as Jerry Jones has been the head of a draft. You know what I mean? And it's just sad. It wasn't that case when Bill Parcells was here. But
well, I'm not down, you know, on this draft just yet. You know, of course, I would have loved to see more excitement, more big name players get picked up, you know, but it wasn't that many in this draft. And we did get a player in pretty much each position. We got an offensive lineman guy, defensive lineman guy. We got another running back, safety, all that, you know. Mm-hmm. I didn't even believe. Didn't we get a linebacker?
Yeah, we got a actually, we got a linebacker from South Carolina. Okay, that was a slash safety.
Mm.
This guy, they are very high on. So
what's his name?
What's his name?
Okay, never mind. Don't worry about it. We'll be watching.
This, I forgot this guy's name. We'll be watching. I forgot this guy's name. But yo, he has the potential to do a little something something. So we'll look out for him, man. We'll
keep in mind we got Sean Lee and other linebacker coming back. So,
well, see that's the thing about the Cowboys, and that's what gets so frustrating about the Dallas Cowboys, and that's one thing that Jerry Jones doesn't realize is that it's a coach's league, man. If we just so happen, okay, let's say every single one of these guys pan out. Let's say every single one of these guys ends up being one of the best players in the league. Guess what? We still ain't gonna win a Super Bowl. The reason is because we don't have a head coach, man. You got to look at the history of the game. When the San Diego Chargers, man, during this salary cap era, the San Diego Chargers have probably had the most talent I've ever seen in this salary cap era. They had the most talent when they had LaDainian Tomlinson, yep, and the quarterback and all of, they had everything. They had everything. What did they not have? A coach. That's the bottom line. And we still got Jason Garrett, who's out here acting like he's the worst coach in the game.
Well, keep in mind, man, you said you was going to give him one more year, JD.
I'm not giving him no more years.
Oh!
No.
No more years?
No.
Not even this season right here.
I'm through.
Oh.
Yeah, and we going 9-7. Hey, hey, I'm in the pessimistic mode. This is – I'm even surprised. I know. I'm surprised myself. Hey, man, I'm more surprised than anybody – in life at how I have just finally figured out, okay, and got to give Dale Hansen, the great Dale Hansen, a lot of credit, because he kept trying to tell us, Jerry the GM.
Tell your ass.
T-Y-A.
He's been killing us. We will never win a Super Bowl until Jerry the GM gets out of here. That's just the bottom line. We'll never win a Super Bowl. I don't care how much, even if we end up being the most talented team in the game, not gonna win a Super Bowl because we have a pitiful coach and the worst GM in the game. Let's talk about some other teams real quick. Picking up, what about Geno Smith?
Yeah, going to the Jets.
Now, this guy kind of favors either a raccoon or a possum.
He do look like something, man. He look like something.
He got to look like something, don't he?
Yeah, he do.
He said a raccoon.
He look like some kind of animal. We're going to have to figure out what that is. I got raccoon and possum on the list.
I'm trying to think of something, but he look like something.
Now they just got 6 quarterbacks. What do you think? And they thinking about getting rid of Sanchez.
Nah, they gonna keep Sanchez. Tebow gonna be out of there. They gonna keep Sanchez, Garrod, and Geno. Watch. They got another quarterback too. I can't remember his name. But they he gone.
They said they wanted Garrod to be a mentor for Sanchez. For Geno.
He might as well be. He can't get no job nowhere else.
why don't they just make Tebow the motivational speaker, man?
What he gonna motivate?
He do the prayer before the game and stuff.
Do the Tebow before the game.
Wow, man. Wow. That's incredible. The Jets continue to just make bad decisions. I don't think Geno Smith gonna pan out for them. Tyrann Mathieu, the Honey Badger, went to the Cardinals. What y'all think about that?
Oh, he went to the Cardinals, huh?
Oh, yeah, he showed it.
Well, the Cardinals need all the help they can get. And, man, and the Cardinals, they've been putting it together here lately. That's a great pickup for them. Yeah. I don't know if it's that good for him.
The Cardinals been putting it together lately. Who they got at quarterback?
Who they just get at quarterback? Was it Carson Palmer or something like that?
No, they got
Kevin Cobb, and they got somebody else that just went there. And then Rashad Mendenhall went there.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? They got Rashad Mendenhall now. They put it together. They still got that defense. They still got Larry Fitzgerald. They put it together.
Well, we'll see, man.
They're definitely making more moves than we in.
You got to most definitely have a quarterback. I don't think Carson Palmer's going to be able to get the job done. But Do you think the honey badger is going to smoke some more weed?
Nah, I think he threw with that, man. He seemed pretty focused out of all the.
He was frustrated at the draft. He was sitting on the couch.
Oh yeah. He was stressed out. He wouldn't smoke a little weed.
Yeah.
He was stressed
out. Did he come back?
Yeah, after the Cardinals called his name. Yeah.
Oh, okay. That's after the Cardinals called his name. Yeah. Though.
Say, man, a lot of people think this guy's going to go on continuing smoking weed. Me personally, I don't think so. I think he's gonna give it up, man. I seen him in the
interview. Already gave it up.
Yeah, I think he gave.
That boy been hanging around Ricky Williams.
Please stay in clear of Ricky Williams if you're trying to get off of the weed. But yo, hopefully that Tyrann Mathieu makes it, man. He got a whole lot of people doubting him. I could tell you that straight up, man. I want to commend this one guy for holding up a sign at the draft that said, "Can we please trade all of our draft picks for a new GM?" And he was, and that was a Cowboy fan.
What?
Oh yeah, I just
man,
had
you should have had Jedi pull the footage up. Man,
I didn't have no footage of him, man. We could try to Google that or something. Maybe somebody does have some. I didn't try to Google it, but dude had a sign up. So that's
a start.
Exactly. That right there proves that we are getting to the public. See what I'm saying? They finally realizing that until we get Jerry Jones out the GM position, we won't be winning no Super Bowl. So, you know, damn talking about. That's why it's so frustrating to sit here and talk about positions and drafts and, oh, who's going to do what. And damn it, it don't matter if you don't have a coach. It don't matter if you don't have a coach. We have a GM that doesn't value that. So that's what we're going to always come back to.
But I did like the statement that Tony Casillas made when he got on stage. The America's team, we are still.
That's right.
Yeah. That's what he said.
That's what he said.
That's my boy.
That's what he said. He got booed like a mug. That's what he said.
Until Pittsburgh, somebody from Pittsburgh came along to talking about the only team that won 6 Super Bowls.
That's what he did. Yeah, he sure did. They cheered on that.
Yeah. Shut up.
And then you see when LeVar Arrington came out there?
Yeah.
He,
what did he say?
They tried to boo him, you know, and he was like, "I am LeVar Arrington. Like, you better get to know me, player, you know."
What he going to do?
He booed him back. Yeah. He's crazy, man. What he going to do?
They should have booed him some more.
The dude that booed was like, boo.
Yo, for real? So they had a dude up there talking about, and what'd he say?
That was Tony Casillas.
Tony Casillas said, what'd he say? We steal America's, what'd he say?
And we steal America's team.
Already. That's Tony Casillas. We're going to always be America's team, even though this is most definitely the dark ages.
But he was trying to dodge something just in case somebody threw something.
threw a tomato at him or something like that. Yo, I'm going to tell you straight up, though, man. These are the dark ages for the Dallas Cowboys, man. So that's all I got to say about that, man. We're going to hope these draft picks pan out for us. We're going to talk a little bit more about the draft picks next week and the upcoming 9-7 Cowboys. We'll talk a lot more about them coming up here. But we got a whole lot more sports talk for you in the second sports segment. Got the news you can use coming on up for you, babies. We love you to death right there, Dark Side Sports Radio.
Get it if you can get it, ain't no sinning, that's how I see it, man. Life ain't about no gossip, oh no questions. How you living, man? Happy in the morning with a mirror in this reflection, man. Do the did you do and do the doing, get your dividends. Respect for zero hate to all of those that do it straight, straight. And quick to wake at 4 in the morning just to get the cake. About that time I'm 35 and heading south up for a date. Daddy wishing there was more with 24, it's always late. Get it how you get it, it don't matter. Make it happen. Split it when you get it, it don't matter. Make it happen. Laying on your hanging, it don't matter. Make it happen. Just keep the haters hating, it don't matter. Make it happen. Get it how you get it, it don't matter. Make it happen. Split it when you get it, it don't matter. Make it happen. Laying on your hanging, it don't matter. Make it happen. Just keep the haters hating, it don't matter. Just make it happen. Get it how you get it. I'ma fucking split it. If it means I'm making money, you know that I'm with it. They call me Loco Lalo. My bullets hollow. Wanna be me? I'm a hard act to follow. Making bitches swallow. I'm a fucking semen. Leave them haters dreaming. And them bitches fiending. And don't let me do a show. Cause when I bust the flow, I'm so out of control. If I push them slow, it's more than a O. First you get the brick, then you break it, you break it. If you're making crack, then you bake it, you bake it. If you don't pay, then I swear to God, I'll take it, I'll take it. Get it how you get it, it don't matter. Make it happen. It don't matter. Make it happen. Just keep the haters hating. It don't matter. Make it happen. Get it how you get it. It don't matter. Make it happen. Split it when you get it. It don't matter. Make it happen. Slanging on your hanging. It don't matter. Make it happen. Just keep the haters hating. It don't matter. Just make it happen.
Let me pass through. And when I let the spiritual light in me pass through, I guess it's just something that come when you grow. Like the positive and negative that come with the throne. But fuck it, I'm strong.
What's going down?
Money, what's it been, man? Where you been at, man?
Man, watch the cartel over here, man. I'm trying to get this little mixtape going down, man.
Oh, this was good.
I guess you think you can donate.
Oh, yeah, you got some beats?
Already, man. I got that here. Something else, man. Come on down.
Oh, yeah, you said nothing. I'm on my way.
That's outside, to that north side, to that east side, and that west side.
That's one thing about old Lalo need. When we meet, we ride these beats. Like phone star freaks on ecstasy. No batteries, little people need. Blowing blows so endlessly. Haters ask how good it be. Tell you, man, this game is easy. Especially after all I've seen. Take a pen, take a scene. Word every moment perfectly. It's on the hook and start singing. Hook up some shows and get money. Leave the fans while still screaming. Hit the blocks with triple B. Get money by many means while dodging all the laws and schemes. Left for us by punk biggies. Knock us off our smooth gaming. Maintain our cool and stay at ease. Never let them see us start sweating. If we do, they'll start winning. Bringing into everything. Won't be no one else to blame. It'll be just me and my PC. Can't complain, no one's listening. Learn to grow and keep moving. Steady grind with no sleeping. Plenty time for that and rest in peace. Till that day, live humbly. Thank our God for each blessing. Doing it so faithfully. I've been waiting for the curtains. Descending,
suicide. Working off a triple beat. Making green by any means. How you think I stay so clean? 13-7's on my ride. Open my door, suicide. Candy paint when I grind. Keep my day in spunky smoke. Santa gold, I'm far from broke. The Velixa, that's who we are. Don't know my name, know my car. Rolling in my 64. Hit one switch, it's on the floor. Lucas begging me for more. The Mexican, UGK. It's okay, I'm in play. Love this rap shit, it's all day. 100 hustles to get paid. Grinding first, thinking hey. I'ma play your business man. Told you once, I told you twice. I'm a fucking man. I'm the type of brutal that take things out of hand.
Southside.
Yo, JD Leo the Lion on the mic with my boy Marvino
the
True.
Marvino the True.
Buopolis Saint with us. We got
man, hold up.
Greatest sleep of all time, sleeping bag Sid.
What it do, players?
Jedi Boss Man on the wheels of steels.
Yo. Hey, Marvino, who is that we just heard?
That's my homeboys, Luna Lalo, Kevlar. Yeah, from Fort Worth. That's Fort Worth right there,
for
man.
For real?
What, them your homeboys, man?
Yeah, man.
What? I
didn't know. Bring them on in the studio, man.
Fort
get them
Worth.
On up in here, man.
Already. Yo, we tried to tell you we got that local talent players.
What they say? They Mexican UGK?
Yeah, the Mexican UGK.
The Mexican UGK. Watch out for them right there, players. Yo, man. Yo, get your neighborhood sports talk right here. We are the AKA People Sports Radio show. What we got for them next?
Giving you the news you can use. Yeah, get this thing
talking
started.
About surprise.
Yeah,
all right. Surprise.
Got my own. Yeah. I was gonna talk. Started out with the Barack coming to town. You know what I'm saying? He was at the all the presidents was at the George Bush Library opening thing at the SMU, which is right down the street from where the studio is, you know?
Yeah.
So Barack came to town. Did you see all the billboards that said, welcome, President Obama?
Nah, I missed him.
Yeah, man, it was all down the highway and everything. And so, I get
why he didn't stop by my house? That was rude.
Well, speaking of stopping by the house, he stopped by Jansen's Jedi's house.
What? Yeah, he did.
Yeah. Told you right down the street from where the library is.
Wow. Yeah, it was really cool. We just got done doing the show, the Pugs Moran show, and I look out the window and there's probably 100 cop cars all parked around that park. And I was like, whoa. So I start looking and they all start driving up Mockingbird and parking in everyone's driveway and putting cones in all of our driveways.
So y'all can't get out.
Yeah, so we couldn't leave, nothing. And two cop cars were each on the end of each driveway, and they said they were real cool, they were nice. They kind of really weren't telling us much, but we knew what was going on. Wait a minute, someone important's coming.
I had a buddy tell me that them putting cones in your driveway and telling you can't come out and all this and that is against the law.
That's what I was about to say.
Well, they didn't say we couldn't come out. Well, but actually the next day, because when we actually saw him twice. I saw him when he came in, and then the next day.
And you threw him somebody through the window.
And then the next day, I saw him when he was going back, and so it wasn't as cool the next day. He had his back to us, and you know, we didn't get to see much. But it was still the same thing.
Oh, he mooned y'all, huh? Yeah. Messed up.
But yeah, it was cool. We got video of it.
Yeah, but we got video of it. You know what I'm saying? If y'all don't believe us, President Obama.
Yeah. This is the video, player.
There he is.
And there he is right here. This is the car that he was in. Y'all can see it.
Oh, yeah, I can see it.
So I could see him like right out this back window. Or actually this side, like, this shape right here.
Yeah.
That's Obama right there.
Now, see, I think that's a lookalike.
No, because he was on his way to a dinner. This lady had, like, paid a bunch of money, like, won, like, a bid or, you know, an auction to have him come eat with her. So that's where he was going.
You know what's so funny about this whole thing? You are not going to tell Jedi that he didn't wave at the president, player. I don't give a damn who you are or where you from. You not finna tell Jedi that he did not wave at the damn president.
That's right.
So awesome. I believe you, player. I believe.
Cat was there. Pugs
was there.
Did you
wave at him too?
Yeah.
She was
sitting right next to me. We were both standing there waving.
But not only that.
He saw us waving. That's when he started waving at us.
But, all three of us.
But not only that, Jedi tell him about how the Secret Service dude, I think he just passed, was like, look, mugging you and shit.
Oh, man,
Oh, you
dude.
See that cop on the bike going?
I thought he was, it was... Yeah, I'm gonna reverse it back. I thought he was gonna jump out his car at me. It scared me. It's this guy right here. He saw me standing there because you gotta understand, we were broadcasting live the whole time.
Yeah.
And I was standing there holding that tripod with the camera on it. It had the wires coming out, and then I had wires connected to a microphone and this whole thing. And so he saw all those wires, and man, it looked like he was about to jump out the car. It was.
I'm going to go ahead and plead straight jealousy right now. And this is two white folk waving at the president. We didn't get to wave at the president. That ain't right. That's not fair. and that's just the bottom line. You know what I'm saying?
No, you should have been there. You knew he was coming.
Was at the wrong place at the wrong time. Just like Jedi didn't tell us about Black History Month. You know what I'm saying? Whatever. Now here we go. He don't want to tell us about Barack coming on through. That's all he could have told us. Barack was about to be rolling through.
Well, if you pay attention to the news, you would have known that too.
Actually, I did know that, but I was like,
"Say, Barack didn't know he was waving at a future millionaire, huh, Jedi?"
Yeah.
Might see him again one day.
Hey, yeah, it really was a cool feeling to see it all, have him wave at me.
You didn't see Michelle though.
Yeah, she was back there too.
You saw Michelle, Jedi, yeah, cold lady.
What?
Yeah, it was
in them dark ass tinted windows. He seen everything.
No, it wasn't dark. It was actually like almost the color of that blue.
What?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you could wow. You could see, yeah. It wasn't darked out at all.
Obama had like a...
Did she wave back too?
No, it was just Obama.
Man. Obama had like a glass of Crown in his hand? With some ice in it?
No, he had
just some ice in it.
No, he had his Remy Martin in his cup.
You know, the black folk, man, is probably more privy to the Crown.
Who drank the Remy Ma?
Nah, he had the kid KD.
Our uncle.
Oh.
I don't know, black folk like that Remy too, man.
Yeah.
You know, we came up with the R and the double R. That's the Remy and the root beer. Oh yeah. That's just
that ain't nobody never.
That's just a little just a little something, something for the fans, you know. That's just, you know,
we giving you that one for free.
Yeah, right. That's for free right there. That's
double R?
Yeah, the double R. You know? That's the Remy and root beer right there. You know what I'm saying? Playoffs.
Don't be trying to go home and sneaking and try, Marvin.
Oh, no, yeah. I might.
Yeah, like, try it out. You're surprisingly smooth.
We have like that goddamn double R.
All right. That's what Barack talking about in the limo. Michelle passed me the double R.
Hey. Man, my news you can use, man. I just been busy this week. You know, it's been a lot of, you know what I'm saying? We had Barack come to town, so that was great. You know, we had, what, all five living presidents? JD, can you name the five presidents that was here?
Got Barack. Got Jimmy Carter. Is it Abraham Lincoln?
You had both Bushes.
Both of the Bushes. Two Bushes. Barack, Jimmy, and Ronald Reagan.
Oh, come on, man.
Nah, I'm tripping. That's my bad, y'all. You know, I just messed with you right there, players. Bill Clinton.
Yeah. Oh, saxophone playing Bill.
Bill did have the sax with him.
Because she was blowing him.
Was Bill in the limo, too? Was Bill in the limo?
Nah. See, you know, we didn't even know who was coming up. We didn't know which president it was gonna be, but we had actually looked up what the beast was gonna look like, which that's what they call it.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
But see,
and so as soon as we saw it, we knew it was him. It was cool.
I think it's very smart that Barack did not have Bill in the limo with him. You know that Bill the player. Yeah. And he gonna try to get up on Michelle and Michelle. You know what I'm saying? And hey, Barack ain't having none of that, player. So, Bill, you ride in about two limos behind us, player. What else you got for us over there? Marvino.
Man, I'm putting it together as we go. But let's keep rolling. I felt the story about old Sean Kelly.
Sean Kelly?
Sean Kelly.
Uh-oh.
I thought you was finna say Sean Kemp when you said that, where that cake came out. You said Kelly. Nah. Who is that?
A married father of nine has been on his job for 16 years.
No, he need that job.
Yep.
He like James on Good Time.
Well, this past January, he got met. He was leaving a Detroit nightclub, and I guess some dude tried to rob him or whatever. You know what I'm saying? The dude ended up shooting him.
Oh, man.
Yeah, it was cold as hell outside. And the only thing he remember about the dude is he had squinty eyes and a gap tooth grin. Okay?
Yeah, okay.
Well.
Squinty eyes and a gap tooth grin. So
sound like Anthony Anderson.
Anthony Anderson.
Anthony Anderson robbed him.
I was thinking of Whoopi Goldberg.
Whoopi Goldberg ain't got no gap.
She ain't got no gap?
No.
I thought she had a little gap right there. I don't know. I might be wrong.
No, and so, you know, shot him or whatever, and he survived. He survived. As time, he ended up going blind in his eye.
Yes. What?
Yes. We're not laughing at him. We're laughing with him.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he's laughing.
Yeah, yeah. Man, now the newest thing for him is they trying to evict him out of his place.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
I got shot.
Right.
What's going on?
And he got nine kids. And he been on the job.
And ain't got no eye no more.
So now he can't work. No, none of that. You know what I'm
saying? Me and you, we can't even see eye to eye no more. They ain't got one of my eyes.
Yeah, he worked as a utilities provider. You know, he ain't not had to leave his job because of the incident.
Oh, man. He should have told this robber that he had 9 kids.
Right.
And maybe the robber would have had gave him some money.
There you go, JD.
Yeah.
That's what he should have did, man. You know what I'm saying? Hey. So, but
you think the robber would have had some sympathy for him? Oh, he would have been like, "Oh, you lying, man. Give me your money anyway.
Anyway,
yeah.
I seen you just come out the club. You know what I'm saying?
What you doing in the club? You got 9 kids. See, I'm gonna shoot your ass flying.
Ain't nothing good going on at 1 o'clock in the morning. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, so." I keep you to stay tuned to that story because we don't know what's going to happen to that. Wow. The last thing I know, he's about to get kicked out. So next week, we'll check it in again on him. All right, I'm going to tell you about Sean Kelly.
Sean Kelly, yo, I want y'all to pray.
And not Sean Kemp.
Not Sean Kemp. But Sean Kelly
from Detroit.
From Detroit, man.
You listening, you know, man?
It's hard in Detroit, by the way. Okay, everybody got a gun. Yo, we want to pray for Sean Kelly, man. That's from the dark side, for real. Pray for old Sean Kelly. He ain't doing
that
good,
wasn't
man.
Sean Kelly. That was Sean P. Diddy Combs.
Ooh. Oh, man. Said Sean Combs, man. You tripping.
All right, well.
Hopefully that brother going to be doing better, though. We don't like to hear stuff like that, man.
Speaking of doing better and don't like to hear stuff like that. Tell you about old Katrina Tisdale.
The hurricane?
No. This chick from St. Petersburg, Florida.
Oh, okay.
You know what I'm saying? She ended up going to jail because she went to the police.
I don't even know why it's so funny. It's because you know something about to come up, man.
Yeah, she was arrested and charged on Monday.
Yeah.
For misusing 911.
Oh, Lord.
You know what I'm saying?
What she called 911 for? Just because she was bored or something? She needs somebody to talk to?
No.
Say, what she you wanted, doing?
She wanted them.
She called 911 to her, what you doing?
No.
You on break?
No, probably something worse than that. She called them and had the police come out because she wanted them to get her for them to go to her drug dealer and get her refund.
Oh, Lord Jesus.
Yep. Good lady.
Oh, Lord Jesus.
Yeah.
You know,
now see that's what happens when you have nothing, when you are nothing but hood. You have been born in the hood. You wasn't even born in the hospital. You was born in the back of the hood and you know what I'm saying, in the crack house or something. And so you done grew up with the hood lifestyle. So now you feel like you want to call the police because somebody didn't do you right on a drug transaction.
Right. Yeah, she got mad because she said she had spent, she had looked up and realized that she had spent her last $50 on cocaine and marijuana. Realized that she was penniless.
Yeah.
She couldn't have that.
So the only people that could help her out.
But hold on, did she smoke the crack and weed before she called the police to get up out of bed?
It don't matter. Obviously not, cause she didn't have none. But what it was, bags, and she was mad as hell. So she was like, you know what? I'm finna call the police.
Yeah, they didn't get none of that back.
So they just went on ahead and took her to jail.
They took her to jail, to Pinellas County Jail, and she is currently there being held.
Ain't that something? You
on a $100 bond.
$100? She can't even pay that.
Nah.
And that's what?
Don't nobody got that. You can find that on the ground. Don't nobody got $100 to get out either. That's a damn shame.
Sorry I keep bringing these terrible stories, man.
Hey,
that's
man.
That's what's going on.
Hey,
right now.
We getting low tonight.
Yeah.
Hey, we getting low tonight, player. Okay? We getting low tonight. That's all I got to say with the news you can use tonight, player. Okay.
Well, speaking of getting low, Man, we got to pray again for our girl Lauryn Hill, man.
Lauryn, and she done had another baby?
No. But, you know, well, she done just came out with a letter, you know, just to her fans and everything saying her tax troubles is true. You know, remember I told y'all about the tax trouble she was having, like she might finna go to jail and all that shit. You know, got all this shit to pay back. But she say she just got a record deal.
Just got a record deal?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah, so she confirmed the record deal and the letter and everything, you know, and say
with
she,
who?
I don't know. I had that for you in a second.
Huh. Rap-A-Lot Records?
No.
Y'all think Rap-A-Lot?
The IRS Records, niggas.
Right. The IRS. Like, yeah, we'll sign you. Everything you get paid comes straight to us. You owe us $31,200,000. That's messed up, man.
Oh, man, she don't even say.
Oh, she done just signed with Stevie J from Love and Hip Hop. She on the track with Jocelyn. Oh, boy, come on, boy. Wow, my girl done fell a long way, bro, right there from the Fugees days.
Nah, she does say, my bad. She said, yes, I have recently entered into an agreement with Sony Worldwide Entertainment.
Oh, Sony Worldwide. Oh, okay. Hey, man, that was that doggone Lauryn Hill, man.
And yes, she is working on new music.
That was my number one. That was a lot of people's number one, man. And next thing you know, she got caught up with the Jamaican Dundada. Jamaican Dundada done, who was that? Bob
Marley.
Yeah, Bob Marley's son. Took her down there. She had about 14 kids, you know what I'm saying? And then he had left her for the white woman from Brazil. And that was it, man. And we haven't heard from her since. But I'm so happy to hear that she fixing to start doing something again, man. Know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Oh, Jedi, you know you got to get excited about that. Over there looking crazy. It's Lauryn Hill, man. Player, come on now.
Yeah, man.
Got to get excited about that. As a matter of fact, play some Lauryn Hill at some point during tonight, man. We got to hear that.
And
at least one song.
And then speaking of Jamaican, y'all remember John Boehner?
John Boehner?
Yeah, House Speaker John Boehner.
Yeah, the House Speaker for the Republicans.
Right. Man, Jensen, pull a picture up of this. Have you ever seen his son-in-law?
Mm-hmm. What's wrong with him?
Man, she pull up a picture of Dominique Lackhan, L-A-K-H-A-N.
Is he like half lobster? He like lobster boy?
No, he from Jamaica.
Oh, he's a Jamaican?
Yeah.
Say, that's tight. Oh, really? That's his son?
His son-in-law, his future son-in-law.
Oh, that's all right.
Why he ain't got him on that gunja, man?
Oh, he about to have him on there. John Boehner about to get real cool. Yeah.
Dominique, it's spelled D-O-M-I-N-I-C.
He finna have a transfer of powers over there.
His last
name
is L-A-K-H-A-N.
He going from Republican to Democratic.
John Boehner sitting up there. Giving Brock a hard time. And this is going to be his son-in-law.
Bob Marley's nephew. Bob Marley's great nephew. John Boehner is about to go through a transformation, folks. I'll tell you that right now. Look, he got his glasses on his hat. Which wouldn't be funny if his hat wasn't so ridiculous.
And he can't actually pass for a terrorist.
He got the greatest Dundada Dr. Seuss hat of all times. He's shopping at the Dundada Dr. Seuss hat store. 20% off on Sundays and Mondays. That's absolutely ridiculous, player.
Yo, man, I hope he does get a hold of John, because John Boehner needs to get something up in his system, player.
Look where he went to eat it.
Where he go to eat it. What is this, a Hoochie Burger? Oh, McDonald's. Now, he eating a nuclear chemical food from McDonald's and everything, boy. Ain't nothing wrong with it, man. Woo!
Got him a 10-piece nugget.
Hey, you never know who your future relatives is going to be, players. That's all you got to know about that, man. That's interesting, though. I bet John Boehner going to try to stay as clear as far away from that dude as he possibly can.
I wonder how he reacted when his daughter told him that she's going to marry him. I wonder what his reaction was.
Oh, you know he probably tried about to convince her for a good 2 days.
That's the daughter right there.
Look at her.
Yeah. Yeah, she look like she wants a little more adventure in her life. Boehner like, go for this Ivy League guy over here. He just graduated from Princeton. Jason Garrett's son.
She look like she got issues anyway.
She like, nah, I want the pot smoking dandata from Jamaica.
Yeah.
That's just how it is, players.
Alrighty, well, shit, man. Hopefully y'all had a good time. Call in.
Yeah,
y'all,
man.
Y'all got more stories, you know. That's the, y'all talk about some sports stuff.
That's the whatever. Famous news you can use right here on the Dark Side Sports Radio Show. We're going to come on back with a whole lot of basketball talk, a little bit of baseball talk, a whole lot of stuff for y'all. We love y'all to death. Bay Bears, Neighborhood Sports Talk, Dark Side Sports Radio.
DFW Metroplex live. DeepElemOnAir.com.
Nigga, get your old biscuit in that old motherfucker. Bean bag, lip bit ass nigga.
Yeah, nigga.
Left foot head ass.
Yeah, yeah. I said,
kinda clean, not a stain on me.
I'm from niggas spitting, women getting car. Place I used to wear big tees, now ain't that bizarre. Started pumping TSR right around the time that DVD has switched from VCR. Shit is kinda modern, so you'll catch us on that DVR. Nah, yeah, very soon, yeah, yeah. We'll be on that channel on lock as you stand in one spot. Said I'm trying to get my money, yeah, yeah, I won't stop. Stand in one spot, keep that channel on lock. Said I'm trying to get my money, yeah, yeah, I won't stop. Stop, stop, stop. Ain't big, yeah, yeah, ain't pop. Ain't here with nigga shot. Don't include Alaska, Hawaii, United States. That mean that Dallas always first in any state. 48. Said I'm from Dallas, Texas. 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 Yeah, start.
started from that Pleasant Grove and the Pro Turfway Drive, Jim Miller Pro. Here we go. Message is a blessing that is spiritual. Bob your head, Bobby Session, music session, miracle. You all want cut short and cold blunt. Yeah, nigga, I said it. Yeah, nigga, I meant it in this city. Plenty niggas on a rap hustle, but Dallas turned to a motherfucking crown bucket. So niggas wanna pull you down when you're climbing up, and niggas wanna mug frown when you're riding up. That be that Dallas pride inside of us. Nigga have 50 chains, Philly cane shining up. Seventh grade came, headed to hood middle school. Parents said, fuck that, pack bags, finna move. I was 12, like, what the hell, Rylan? Looking back on it, only thing to call it progress.
Nothing lasts forever, so I play above the rim. Got my jersey and my sneakers, now I'm jumping at the gym. Oh yeah, bitch, bitch, yeah, yeah, hey, hey. Nothing lasts forever, so I play above the rim. Got my jersey and my sneakers, now I'm jumping at the gym. Oh yeah, yeah. Take a part of the beat and I eat. Be straight for 4.5 weeks. Like the Paramount, big worm, big hoe. I don't give a damn, I unleash the beast. The coldest of the volcanoes that's pushing heat. Hopefully you brought your bed, so I won't give you a place to sleep. You could take this in or let it be, like after 8 and that's me. Either way it be, I'm second to none and you second to dumbest if you believe that I ain't Wesley, undisputed champ. Ain't lost a thing but a peaceful mind in this world of hate, in this world of fake and phonies. Come on, I in on my grind for a very long time. Bro, I got so much firepower. The military talking about dropping my next album. Who ain't about it? To those at the top of Everest Mountain, I'm the bomb. I will bring napalm out to Nepal, ring alarms and black out like red into cow. Back down on background, I hope you draw the foul. Doing what I gotta just to make it all happen. You just see the execution, you don't tune into the practice. All my life my family struggling, and since I'm the last dragon, I won't stop until I have it. Living good and living lavish. Doing what I gotta, host the Lord don't rate it. Denied the right to live the life that everyone's portraying. I'm Southern and I love it, but some motherfuckers hate it. Put the city on my back, if you don't give it, I'ma take it from ya. Bitch, nigga, bitch, nigga, bitch, nigga, bitch, nigga, bitch, nigga. Nothing lasts forever, so I play above the rim. Got my jersey and my sneakers, now I'm jumping at the gym. Oh yeah, bitch, nigga, bitch, nigga, bitch, nigga, yeah, yeah. Hey, nigga, ain't nothing left forever, so I play above the rim. Got my jersey and my sneakers, now I'm jumping at the gym.
Sit back and take notes. I take a toke from the marijuana smoke. Jamming hot boys, I'm on fire, so now you know. Just how I feel, so I will wreck a mic like Michael Randall. Piss drunk behind the wheel. Not a diss to kill a mic, but shit, I'm coming here to win. And if it's coming with a fight, then I'm coming at your chin with 20 pounds of dynamite. A prostitute that work for NASA, about to blow you out of sight. I hope the time come faster. See, I been on my grind for a very long time. She still got a long way to go, like commuting on feet from the east to the west coast. Try to hang but cut the rope, cause I'm coming at your throat. In the booth like telephones making change. Fuck a hope, let them know. If I make it to 20, 24. It's cause Kobe gave me his jersey. This quarter I go for 30. Doing what I gotta just to make it all happen. You just see the execution. You don't tune into the practice. All my life my family struggling. And since I'm the last dragon, I won't stop until I have it. Living good and living lavish. Doing what I gotta just the Lord don't grade it. Denied the right to live the life that everyone's betraying. I'm Southern and I love it, but some motherfuckers hate it. Put the city on my back, if you don't give it, I'ma take it from ya. Bitch, nigga, bitch, nigga, bitch, nigga, bitch, nigga. Nothing lasts forever, so I play above the rim. Got my jersey and my sneakers, now I'm jumping at the gym on ya. Bitch, nigga, bitch, nigga, bitch, nigga. Hey, nothing lasts forever, so I play above the rim. Got my jersey and my sneakers, now I'm jumping out the gym, y'all.
Dark Side Sports Radio, Saturday, 6 to 8 p.m.
Yo, JD Leo the Lion on the mic with Marvino
the
Truth.
We in the house.
Pewopolis is not here. We got Greatest Sleep of All Time, Sleeping Bag Sid.
Man, what's going on?
Jedi's on the Wheels of Steels.
Yo.
Gonna try to get into some UFC talk and baseball and basketball talk, but wanted to try to start it off, man, with the UFC. Okay.
We got John Jones and Chael Sonnen tonight. Hopefully y'all getting somewhere. Getting front row seat.
John Jones Bones.
John Bones Jones.
John Bones Jones, presently the greatest UFC fighter.
In light heavy, anyway.
In light heavyweight history so far, okay. Fighting this guy, white man named Sonnen.
Chael Sonnen.
Chael Sonnen. Chael Sonnen is 36 years old. John Bones Jones
like 23 or something.
25 years
25,
old.
Yeah.
The 36-year-old Sonnen has a 73 reach. John Bones Jones has an 84 reach. The 36-year-old Sonnen is 6'1".
Mm-hmm.
John Bones Jones is 6'4". Dog, this is,
that don't really mean anything, though, JD. That don't really, look at Mike Tyson. Mike Tyson was shorter than everybody he fought.
Yep. And we were just talking about that at work.
You know what I'm saying? And he was knocking people out. And especially in UFC where you can actually grab the guy, you know? Mike Tyson was just straight hands with it and was still, you know, doing his thing. In UFC, you can kick somebody. You can kick somebody in their stomach, you know what I'm saying? And all kind of, you can grab them. I mean, it's like just a lot of different techniques with it. And that is what he's mastered. His size helps him to a certain extent, but in UFC, oh man, anything goes, man.
You remember how when people always ask you, what do you think Floyd Mayweather would do to Manny Pacquiao? What did you always say?
I said he'd beat the shit out of Manny Pacquiao.
Well, that's pretty much the same thing that's going to go down with John Bones Jones and this nigga son, and this dude Sonnen, man. Oh, excuse me.
Money jaw.
I gotta put one in the money jaw. I pulled a Stephen A. Smith. Excuse me. What had happened is this guy is the world champion. Is the difference?
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. No, I'm rooting for John Jones.
And
now
the difference between Mike Tyson and Sonnen is Mike Tyson was young. Yeah, he was undersized, but this guy was like a bull. He was young, had a lot of power. Sonnen is 36 years old. Come on now.
Yeah, I think John Jones is going to get him. I'm not saying Chael's going to beat him or anything. I'm just saying in as far as size, that really don't matter as much in UFC.
So the question then remains is, how quick is this fight going to be? I mean, because me personally, I'm thinking this is going to be one of the quicker fights.
I'm thinking it's going decision.
In UFC, history. What?
Yeah, I think it's going decision.
Why do you think that? Please.
Because John ain't going to get in there and, I mean, he'll like throw like a lethal blow like once around. You know what I'm saying? And other than that, he going to grapple with you and wrestle on the ground with you and all that. You know what I'm saying? I think it's going to be one of them kind of fights. I think it's going to be one of them wrestling around, and it ain't going to be like no stand-up kind of fight.
The fights that the fights that I've seen John Bones Jones fight, man.
Oh, yeah, I've seen all his fights. And I've seen John Jones, somebody throw a punch, and he grab on their arm.
Yeah.
And his whole body just on their arm, and they go to the ground. Yeah, I've seen all that. But I know Chael's going to lose. You know what I'm just saying?
I don't think this is going to a decision whatsoever, man. John Bones Jones right now is at the height, man, of his career. I'm talking about 25 years old. You want to talk about somebody being in the prime?
Prime, yep.
As far as his age. And when you hear this guy speak, man, he is, to me,
you're intelligent.
He's like a Mike Tyson with a ridiculous brain, dog. That's exactly what he is to me.
Ridiculous
isn't
like good.
Isn't good. He's like Mike, an intelligent as hell Mike Tyson is what John Bones Jones remind me of in his profession. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Hey, dog. I mean, he brings a whole lot of logic to the table, and he got a whole lot of moves which are very, very spectacular, which we will see him put on Sonnen tonight. You know what I predict?
And the hype before the fight that's been building up, because you know they could have fought before.
Yeah.
And John Jones turned it down or whatever, you know?
Yeah.
And so Dana White was upset about that. It was like
he turned it down.
Yeah.
You know why he turned it down?
Because he was going to kill him.
Exactly. So it's not going past two rounds for me.
Two rounds? Yeah,
not past two rounds for me. So you say it's going to go ahead and go to this?
I think it's going to be a decision, yeah.
Okay. All
right. I think it's just going to be one of them fights.
I said two rounds.
Two rounds?
Yeah.
All right. You'll give old son in two rounds. Okay. Yeah.
Sonnen gonna beat up and toe down at the end of the decision, but
okay.
I just think it's gonna be one of them, cause you know, it's not that I'm trying to do the conspiracy like Pew, but you know, people came to see the fight. They gonna give the fans, you know, a show. You know what I'm saying? I think it's just gonna be one of them.
Mike Tyson, we all thought he was gonna give us.
Was gonna knock somebody out. You know, you couldn't tell Mike, just go easy right here on in, so we can, you know.
But that's the way fighting and boxing is. You don't. Yeah. What you talking about putting on the show? No, you gonna get knocked out. You talking about putting on the show? You got to get in there and fight.
Yeah.
So the Rangers have won 16 games.
Yeah, buddy, the Rangers been looking good.
Number one in the AL, right?
Won 16 games, lost 7. Oh. These guys are rolling.
I meant to bring this picture up of Ron Washington. Y'all see that picture?
Yo, we're not going to talk about that right now.
Did you see that picture, though?
We're going to bring that up a little bit later on, player. Okay. Don't even mention that. Okay. Nah, we're going to bring that up just a little bit later.
Oh, man.
But we're going to talk about the Rangers' pictures, man. You know, we missing some pretty standout pitchers, Matt Harrison and Kobe Lewis. But we messed around and picked up Justin Grimm and Nick Tepish, who are doing a fantastic job, man. Just on Friday, Justin Grimm won a game 4-3 over the Twins. Ended up throwing 7 straight shutout innings, man, to win his second consecutive start. He beat Seattle back on Sunday, who was I just talking about, man?
What'd you say his name was?
Justin Grimm.
Grimm, yeah.
Yeah, we beat the Twins on Friday. So that was the second consecutive win, man. Nick Tepish, the day before that, beat the Twins and ended up only got one run on this guy.
Now he did real good, man. Darvish didn't play that day though, huh?
Both of these guys are rookies. Yu Darvish is 4-1. Ron Washington said they believed in these guys. They knew that they had talent. They weren't too particularly sure what they was gonna do when they got out there, but he knew that they were not afraid, man.
So what you say your prediction was with the Yu Darvish wins this year? With the Rangers?
I said, 18? Over 18 is what I put them at?
I said 17. What'd you say?
I think it was 18 is what I put. You Darvish said 18 and over for you Darvish on the wins, man.
Yeah, I think I had said something.
He's already got a great start, man. But it's just nice to see that these two guys, these young pitchers, Justin Grimm and Nick Tepish, is stepping on. Hopefully they can keep it up, man. You know, hopefully
they going to keep it up.
Hopefully they can keep it up.
We going to get on in these playoffs, man, and that's when it's going to decide what we're going to do, man. We going to get to the playoffs, believe that.
We got to give Ron Washington a whole lot of credit for keeping this team steady. You know, Lance Berkman is coming in here doing a nice job. Our bats are hot. And we won 16 games, man, out of 23. We just rolling right now. You got to love it. And it's one more thing I want to say about the Rangers, man. Give Ron Washington a lot of credit. No doubt about it. But this pitching coach, man, that the Rangers have, they should never, ever, ever, ever get rid of this guy, man. And that's just the bottom line. Every pitcher that comes through here is doing a phenomenal job, it seems like. And you got to give that pitching coach a hell of a lot of credit for that. Don't ever let that guy go, along with Ron Washington. We got to get on to the basketball talk, man. Okay.
Yeah, playoffs is in full spring right now. Let's do it, baby!
And Chicago has made you officially look bad because they have pulled off the victory and with all their starters fouled out the game in triple overtime.
Wow, so they what, 3-1 right now?
Yes, sir.
Ooh.
The Nets should really be ashamed. They are simply getting out-hustled and muscled by an inferior basketball team. PJ Carlissimo should be choked again. We need to bring a Spreewell back to choke this guy again or something like that. I don't know what's going on with this.
The famous choker.
Let me tell you something, man. These guys have one of the best point guards, arguably the best point guard in the league, and Darren Williams. They got a shooting guard in Joe Johnson who will most definitely disappear on you. Not a superstar, even though he's getting paid superstar money, but he can most definitely score. They got three dirty players, man, in Evans, Blanche, and Humphreys. They got Lopez, who is this year the second best center in the game, okay, because the center for the 76ers was out the whole year.
Andrew Bynum, Andrew Bynum, my boy. That was a good pick.
Yeah, Andrew Bynum was a good pick. But Andrew Bynum, who was out the whole year. So Lopez, second best center in the game. You got two solid backup point guards, Watson. You got everything. I don't understand why the Brooklyn Nets are losing this series. These guys are soft. I had to put the T on the end of that because they are soft. The only reason they are getting beat is because they are getting out-gritted. And yes, that's just the bottom line, 100. It was like they scored 200 points today in the game. How you going to let another team score 200 points on you Brooklyn Nets? And then, you know, let's call them the New Jersey Nets. They the New Jersey Nets again. Y'all shouldn't even have the doggone, you know what I'm saying, privilege to be called a Brooklyn Nets. You the New Jersey Nets again.
Damn.
This is ridiculous, man. Down three games to one. Oh, hell yeah. Do not make me look bad, players.
Yeah, I think Brooklyn was going to sweep or something like that. Yeah.
I thought Brooklyn was going to win this series in six games.
And what's so bad about it? They did it without Derrick Rose.
Did it without Derrick Rose.
And it hurt Joel Nokin.
And Joakim Noah. By the way, is not hurt, okay? He's sitting up here talking about, I got needles in my... Yeah, right. By the way, he jumping for that like 17 feet alley-oops. You know what I'm saying? Whatever, player. Your feet is not hurt anymore. You good. You
but
good
speaking
to go,
of being
man.
Hurt, what about that boy Westbrook, man? Out for the rest of the playoffs? Woo! Okay. That's going to hurt.
Westbrook, what do you think the OKC is going to do now? I think they're going to get past Houston. Do you think they're going to get past the Los Angeles Clippers in the second round?
Ooh. That's a hard one right there.
The only reason why I say they probably wouldn't is because of the big man in the middle.
That's a hard to call one right there.
It is. But at the same time.
If they do, I'm rooting for the Clippers to take the whole thing. But, that's a hard one right there. I say Clippers in seven.
I'm going to go ahead and say the Clippers are probably in six or seven. Let me go ahead and say Clippers in six, okay? And that's because I don't think they're going to be able to replace Westbrook's scoring.
No.
They got Kmart Martin coming off the bench, who is a serviceable, most definitely serviceable, and one of the best basketball IQ players in the league, in my opinion. But
when you get thrown in that position in the midst of the playoffs.
And the thing about it is, a lot of people, what do they always criticize Westbrook for? Shooting too much. The problem is one of the reasons he had to shoot so much is because he had to. They don't have other scorers on the team. Westbrook's mainly the other scorer until Kevin Martin comes in the game. So now you losing a guy that can at any night put up 30 or 40. That's gone now. So, I mean, I just think this is a league of superstars. You can't replace a guy like that, man. And that's just the bottom line.
Westbrook's
man.
Attitude did him in it, though.
No, it didn't, yeah, man. It was just a bad play.
He got a bad attitude, man.
So you think it's always karma?
Yes. Yes, dog. He just got into it with somebody else the other day. You know, remember on the side of the court? I can't remember who he got into it with. And the dude was trying to help him out. No, something going on with him, man.
That dude was antagonizing him. He was doing the Dennis Ross the whole game, and that's how he was getting into West. And he actually did get into Westbrook's head. Yeah, he got into Westbrook's head because
it's easy to do.
And then, but you know, when he ran, and at first I thought it was a dirty play when he ran into Westbrook. But when I went back and reviewed it, I can't say it was a dirty play. I mean, he was going for the ball. Unfortunately, Westbrook, and you gotta remember, man, Westbrook hasn't been hurt in elementary, high school, or the pros. So, you know, that's something new for him. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, my prediction of the Lakers beating the Spurs is a shot to hell. With the Spurs last night, the starting point guards being some guys named Riff Raff and
Mumbo.
Mumbo and
Scooby-Doo
and Jenna Mark Duhon or something
and
like
Casper.
That. So Nash, Blake, and Jody Meeks all got hurt, which is amazing. That's a for the whole backcourt. The Lakers just have the worst luck of any franchise this year, it seems like. So they were all out. Spurs beat the hell out of them, and Tim Duncan is looking fabulous. The greatest power forward of all times is healthy.
Yeah, he is.
He's older, but man, he is just, and man, this year you gotta say he's one of the top five, maybe even top three power forwards in the game.
He just stuck to the basics his whole career. None less.
Man, and he is really, 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 really looking good, man. Boston beat up on the New York, Boston got beat by the New York Knicks, and the sixth man of the year got ejected for elbowing somebody in the chin. Can you believe that, man?
Well, it's the playoffs, man. It get rough.
Why did he let the Jet Terry get into his head, especially when they were beating them down? You know what I mean?
Yeah, well, it happens.
Come on, player. gotta be a little, but you know, you gotta have a little bit more poise than that. You know what I'm saying?
That's why they told him. Well, yeah, know that now.
That's
but
why they told him to turn your ass.
It's been a bad year for Jason Terry, right?
Yeah, yeah, he got dunked on.
He got dunked on, man. He got like
that. Did you see LeBron when he was talking about that on the press conference?
What'd he say?
Man, he was like, it couldn't have been on nobody better, dog.
What?
Because you remember when Jason Terry hit the three on him when we won the championship?
Yeah.
Remember that? He ain't never forgot that, dog. Think, Jason yeah, Terry hit that, comment, and that, it hit the bottom of the net.
And then he made it.
Y'all remember that?
Yeah.
He don't like that.
He just made a comment. Yeah, and so that always stuck with LeBron. And he was like, it couldn't have been on nobody better, you know what I'm saying?
I think he made a comment to LeBron James talking about, we beat y'all on y'all own floor, too.
Yep. And so, yeah, he dunked on Jason Terry.
So, the Jet, man, is, I don't know, man. Yeah, he's had a bad year, man. But how much longer do you think KG and Chris and Paul Pierce is going to play?
Not much longer. Yeah, Not much longer.
Probably about another year.
I give him two.
Man, the road is coming to an end. Yeah. They might have their fishing rods for life, man, after this year. You think either one of them might retire, or you think they both gonna try to stay?
What, in Boston?
Yeah,
I think they both go try to retire in Boston. Especially Paul Pierce, he gonna retire in Boston. I'll be shocked. You know, even though he's from LA and everything, he might try to play with LA like one season before he retires.
For some reason, man, I think Paul Pierce might retire. I don't know why, but I think he might retire, man. I think he might be like, man, yo, you know, I had my good run. I got my millions.
You seen him sitting up in the Raptors looking long-faced and shit.
Depending on his contract. I got to look at that again. But look out for that, man. The Warriors, before we get on up out of here and try to get to the break, man, I want to talk about the Warriors. And I want to talk about the
Pacers.
It was the Warriors playing the Denver Nuggets. But actually, I thank you for saying the Pacers. How do you think the Knicks versus the Pacers series is gonna pan out?
Pacers can sneak them.
Don't you see a lot of physicalness going on?
Oh yeah.
During this series.
Yeah.
A lot of fights. Hey, J.R. Smith just got, you know, ejected for elbowing somebody. Hey, you think Jason Terry got under your skin? The Pacers, man, they can get under your skin. You know what I mean?
Well, maybe thankfully, since he got into it with Jason Terry, that he'd be calm now. You know, he can't get in too much more trouble.
So who do you see coming out of that series, the Knicks or the Pacers?
I say the Knicks.
Say Knicks? How many games?
Knicks in six.
Knicks in six.
Woo! Yeah, I'm gonna have to go ahead and roll through Knicks. I want to say Pacers, but they really ain't got no matchup for the Knicks.
You know what? I'm going to actually say the Knicks in seven, man. I think the Pacers. You say the Knicks in six? I say the Knicks in seven. I think the Pacers is gonna come with a whole lot of grittiness, man.
They playing who right now?
Right now they playing Boston. They finna expose them. They playing Boston.
The Pacers.
No, the Pacers are playing the Hawks.
Yeah.
So the Pacers about to beat the Hawks. So these two teams are about to meet one another.
Yeah, the Pacers ain't got nothing for the Knicks.
Pacers ain't got nothing for the Knicks, and I'm right there with you on that. But I just think at some point, the Knicks perimeter shooting and Carmelo Anthony putting up too many perimeter shots and forgetting about going inside and maybe hitting the closer baskets is going to get them in trouble. That's why I think it's going to go seven.
Because it all goes back to what you talk about. It goes through the big man, and they not, and
and Hibbert ain't too bad, though. Don't slip on Hibbert.
Nah, I ain't slipping, but you know, you got, who that dude we had over there? I can't think of his name.
Who you talking
for
about?
The center for the Knicks.
The center for the Knicks?
Yeah.
Oh, you talking about Tyson Chandler.
Yeah.
Yo,
that
man,
boy, that boy ain't letting them come down easily right there, player.
The Knicks got a lot of weapons. It turns out the Golden State Warriors have a lot of weapons. Playing the Nuggets, I picked the Nuggets to win this series in six. Look at here, man. I'm starting to get upset, player.
First, I had the Nets flip out on me, okay? Now, the Warriors are beating up on my Nuggets. You know what I mean? And just dipping them on in the sauce, sweet and sour, ranch.
Barbecue.
And barbecue, most definitely, is the most famous one.
Zesty.
But they should not be winning this series, man. I might have to go to coaching. I usually don't talk about coaching when it comes to basketball because I feel basketball is most definitely a player's league. But having said that, these two teams are pretty, you know, they're paired pretty closely. The parity, there's a lot of parity right there. So coaching is going to have to be maybe a slightly more significant factor. And it's turning out that your boy Jackson, Mark Jackson, is out coaching. George Karl,
he coaching, boy.
Mark Jackson coaching this. That boy Mark Jackson
hands
coaching
down,
his,
man down.
Yo, hands down, man down.
Yeah, that shit paying off, man.
He is coaching his butt off over there, man. And George Karl is suspect. I'm going to tell you straight up. George went to the finals and lost to Michael Jordan one year when he had Sean Kemp and Gary Payton. But I remember, I believe it may have been a year or maybe a year before, year or two before that. He lost with Gary Payton and Sean Kemp in the first round to a pedestrian Nuggets team that had Mutombo and a bunch of other guys you never heard, you know, you forgot about, you know. And it's just George Karl, man. He had Carmelo Anthony with AI on the same team. I mean, still didn't get to the finals. I mean, yo, George Karl, man, he may not be as great of a coach as some think he is, man. And maybe he's pretty good. I don't know about great.
Well, speaking of good and great, man, I bought Michael Jordan.
You got some Michael Jordan.
Yeah, you said you had brought up Michael Jordan.
Go ahead
thing,
on,
you know?
with your so bad self.
You know,
right
we in the midst of the playoffs and everything that's going on. You know, the teams that's not in it making some changes. You know what I'm saying? They doing a lot of reworking.
Yeah,
everybody know our boy Michael Jordan. You know, is part owner of the Bobcats or something like
yeah.
that.
Yeah.
Well, he done fired his fifth coach.
Oh
yeah, his fifth coach in 7 years.
He's gonna go out there and get Avery Johnson.
That's not looking good for MJ, man. Come on now, his fifth coach in 7 years. That's cold.
I'm gonna go down coach with MJ.
Yeah. So my question I want to ask you, who's the worst GM, MJ? Or
Jerry Jones.
I don't give a damn what you say.
By far.
Extended
that one. Yeah, that was the extra extension on the vocals for that one. Now, and that's because Jerry's been in it for 17 years. You know, this is like the 18th, going on eight next year. Yeah. It's gonna be the 18th year that we have not won a Super Bowl. So, and that's all because Jerry, the GM, is the worst GM in the game.
Yeah, but some of the picks that Michael Jordan did, man, it was enough to scratch your head.
Kwame Brown, which they later named Crummy Brown. Adam Morrison, dog, they say he missed on so many players, man. And as a matter of fact, man, I'm going to try to, we're going to get those players for you next weekend.
Yeah,
man.
We'll get them for you next weekend.
We'll get them for you next weekend.
Yeah, and I also want to tell you, I don't know if you was watching your boy Stephen A., you know?
Yeah.
But
Stephen A., the Michael Jordan of the debaters. Uh-huh.
Right.
Go ahead.
He says that Michael Jordan ain't the problem.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he says he defers a lot to his homeboys. And but, I mean, yo, It's also Michael Jordan's fault because, you know, he has the final say so. And, yo, man, some guys just can't judge talent. That's just the bottom line, you know. A lot of people, you know, have played sports and know sports in a different in certain ways, but you may not know how to judge talent. Me, personally, I've always told people I don't know how to judge talent from a college, you know, football players coming to the pros. I can't tell you.
So if you had an opportunity to coach for Michael Jordan, would you go do it?
Oh, most definitely, yeah. Man.
He done the fifth coach in 7 years.
Man, most
your definitely. Ass is gonna be up out of here.
I would have him out of here.
Yeah, you gonna pay. Leave. You gonna leave with a bitter taste.
Boy,
in your mouth.
I would have that team rolling. I have that team rolling, boy. Me and Michael Jordan be smoking cigars, boy.
Oh,
boy,
man.
We be having that team
rolling.
I don't
rolling know about like no cigars.
Yo, we going to go ahead and try to go on to the break, man. We love y'all to death. Thank y'all for listening, man. 6 to 8 on Saturdays. Don't be late. We love y'all to death. Dark Side Sports Radio. Like a nigga up a fist of crime to make hits. Don't skateboard, but I'm on the grind to get rich. Gotta get my cake up. When I wake up, know I gotta bake up. Mary Jane in my head and I'm tryna shake her. If you ain't fucking with Dunny, you a hater. So you later. Fuck how you living, I'm making a killing. Money so high, it's detaching the ceiling. But bitch, I'm so high, my head might hit the ceiling. My squad in this bitch, we gon' break down the building. Fuck how you living, I make you my victim. Blows are disgusting and sickening. Ignorant, ridiculous. Y'all dickless, straight bitches. My bitches, young pimpin'. I pimp pins and I flip shit on my crib shit. Say cousin, this a picnic and I'm picky. So I'm getting it till I'm rich, rich. All you niggas just acting. I lead this shit, fuck rapping. Magicians playing y'all tricks. Well, I run this bitch, stupid rabbit. Came to wreak havoc. Fuck fame, you can have it. Keep a little change with my habits. And a bad bitch with no attachments. Anything I'm on is tragic. Only thing I want is lavish. I see you pussy still laughing. But fuck you, I'm about to ask you. Staring at me funny. You ain't never seen a dragon. I just came to bring hell.
Mama so sick in this night while I sit. No need to trip, too fly for this. Too high to sit, who's stopping this? Not I, you bitch. Better recognize what you get when fucking with B.O.I. in this bitch. Take a sit, take your bitch, give it back to you. Slavery in, whole nigga blocking ain't letting me in. Fuck it, run the ass over with the Billy train. Bitch, it's Billy gang, brain gang, money gang. Doing the kush, brought the kush and the Jane. Focus on greatness, fuck that fame. Cuff your dame, too busy getting changed. Fuck with the gang, nigga, two to your brain.
Murder, I still hear voices in my head. Shotgun shells, AK cases. I live and see motherfuckers dead. Tell from the crib, the valley of the death in the dumb in the motherfucking blind. The all see I never seen my kind. Blood money drives me if you read my mind. Murder, plum red. I still hear voices in my head. Shotgun shells, AK cases. I live and see motherfuckers dead. Tell from the crib, the valley of the death in the dumb in the motherfucking blind. The all see I never seen my kind.
Niggas be faking, bruh. Rapping about shit they making up. These niggas get stabbed smoking angel dust while I'm making videos getting paper, bruh. That's why they hating, huh? Fuck these niggas, I was raised a stunt. On these hoe ass niggas, bring some hoes in, nigga. They gon' roll them switches and I'm with my niggas, so you know that's Billy. Baby, they be hoe, I be posted up chillin'. With a bad bitch that's tryna take pictures. Just leak him on the internet and stun on them bitches. I told that hoe, you ain't gotta be silly. Matt Clay in this hoe, nigga. Space Boy in this hoe, nigga. Dooney Kush in this hoe, nigga. Triple D in this hoe, nigga.
Murder, I'm red. I still hear voices in my head. Shotgun shells, AK cases. I live to see motherfuckers dead. Tell from the crypt, the valley.
see my kind. Blood money drives me if you read my mind.
The Lion on the mic with Marvino the Truth.
Yeah, we in the house.
Buobalus is not with us. We got the greatest sleep of all time, sleeping bag said.
Giving you what you need, baby.
Jedi Boss Man Jansen on the wheels of steels. Gonna get into a little bit of damn it, I'm from the old school right here, players.
Oh shit. Sorry.
Turn it up on us.
Yeah, you got it.
Damn it, I'm from the old school.
Yeah.
Yo, man.
Yeah. What you got for us today, Jay? Easy.
Tonight on the Damn It, I'm from the old school, man. It's why are we micing up the coaches in the playoffs?
Oh, you don't like that, huh? But they've always done that, man.
In basketball and the NBA?
Oh, in basketball and the NBA?
Yeah. What are you doing?
I guess they saw football doing it. They just doing that for the fans, you know what I'm saying? So it could be more interactive and you can hear what's going on.
But how many times have we seen coaches get so animated and just wanting to get on their teams and they're cursing, man, and they just... I mean, cuss words just flying all over the place. But they can't do that now because they got a microphone clipped on to their jacket.
And damn it, you from the old school.
Yeah. Damn it, I'm from the old school. The coach can't really be a coach if he's trying to put on a show for the fans. You feel
right,
me?
Yeah.
I'm not trying to put on a show. I'm trying to do my job.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't need to be mic'd up, man.
But don't you think it makes it better for the fans?
Man, so you type of insight on what they're talking about.
I think maybe in football it does, because football you just basically don't have a choice but to focus. You know what I'm saying, on the game. But I mean, basketball, look, man, just put all that stuff away, man. We don't need all of that, player.
I'm
from the old school. We don't. It's just ridiculous, man. The coaches.
That's why you from the old school.
You know these coaches want to curse. That's all I'm saying. I don't condone, you know, want the coaches to curse. I'm just trying to say that the coaches want to curse. And they doing it all the game long. So when they got the microphone on, it's like, oh, man.
Okay, that means what, Golden State probably going to win the championship then. Because, you know, the coach got his hand down, man's down. He ain't got to cuss. You know what I'm saying? He's still going to be able to do his thing. You know what I'm saying? His hands down, man's down.
Hands down, man's down.
So, you know, going to keep it rolling.
Well, that's just my thing, man. You know, the microphones, man. Let's get them off for the coaches, man.
Like the mics.
You like the mics? What about you, man?
Yeah, I can dig with the mics. I can dig
it. I don't like it.
Can you dig it, sucker?
Well, let's try to just move on then, dog.
What else you got? You ain't got no more Debbie from the old school?
That was it, man. I just had that one, man. And, you know, that's just
Debbie, he's from the old school.
Yeah, you know, I saw the mic on the PJ Carlissimo, and you know he likes to get down and dirty. I mean, he done been choked before, so. But he couldn't even get down and dirty because the microphone was on his on his jacket. So
that means
then
you got to read the lips. Sometimes you're not going to be able to read the lips, man.
yeah. He whispering in the player's ear.
You should just tell him to say the coaches, when they feel like they need to cuss, they just need to say, damn it, I'm from the old school.
Yeah. And they know to mic it out.
Right.
Yo, man, let's try to get on to some come on player, I suppose, because I got about five come on players, man.
Let me go ahead,
man.
Get out the way then, because you got about a million over there.
What you got, sleeping bag, Sid?
So I was listening to my partner the other day, and he tell me somebody tried to break into the house. It's in somebody's house. Well, they broke into the house.
Oh, that's bad.
Yeah, but check this out. When they broke in, they thought somebody else was in the house.
Somebody else was in the house, though.
Well, hold on, Marvito. Well, he was hearing all kinds of noises. So the burglar that was in the house, when he thought he heard another noise, he decided to call the police.
Oh.
And when the police came out, they discovered it was a cat in the house.
You got to be lying, man.
No, Flair.
This happened in Dallas?
No, it didn't happen in Dallas, though.
Okay. So a burglar broke into a house.
You
know, got scared by a noise?
By a noise, because he thought somebody else was in the house.
So why he just didn't run away?
I guess he still was trying to steal.
Yeah.
But because he heard noise, he called the police.
Oh, man. That was a crackhead right there. You said he had a cell phone, though.
No, he used the house phone.
2013?
For real.
And when the police came out, they discovered it was a cat that was in the house that was making all the noise.
Please, let me make sure I'm not confused. So, a burglar breaks into a house, right? He's a burglar. Okay. Broke into the house. So then he hears some rumblings,
decides to call the police from the house phone.
See, that's all I need to know right there.
And so the whole time, the homeowner is there, right?
No, it wasn't nobody there.
Oh, okay.
No.
Oh, okay.
But it was a cat that was in the house that was making a noise.
That cat was making a weird ass noise. Scared the hell out of him. He was like, it's something wrong with this. Yeah.
And he got arrested for breaking in the house.
Come on, player. I wouldn't even arrest him. I'll just put him in the psychiatric ward, man. And Let him talk to good four psychiatrists a day or something like that. I don't even believe in psychiatrists, but he needs one. Ooh, that's pitiful right there, player. I just got a few. First of all, I want to come on player Brandon Jennings. He said that they was going to win the series against the Heat in six games. The point guard for the Milwaukee Bucks. They already down three games to nothing. So,
come on, player.
Come on.
Come on,
player. Even though I will give him commend him for being, you know, believing in himself. More power to you right there, player. Speaking of power, I just wanted to come on, player, my black power homeboy Hustle Man.
Hustle Man, what he done did?
Yeah, man, you know, that's your homeboy. You know, he comes around, you know what I'm saying? You know, it's your homeboy. You know, he gonna sell you some soap.
Yeah.
You know, black man soap, you know what I'm saying? You know, black man ain't got the same skin as white man, you know what I'm saying? Black man got different skin than the white man. You gotta get the soap, you know what I'm saying?
So he you're right. Or he'll sell you a real fake gold chain.
Yeah, you don't wanna buy no gold chain from the white man. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it's all different type of stuff. But man, when it got out of hand, man, it's when, man, all of a sudden, man, next thing you know, that black man tried to sell me some toothpaste.
Oh, man.
I'm like, damn, I didn't know, man. You know, I didn't know our bodies was all genetically different like this. You know what I'm saying?
So he tried to sell you on the toothpaste.
With the toothpaste, man.
Like, you why know? You should buy this toothpaste?
Black man got different teeth and gums than a white man. White man got different gums than a black
what
man.
What was the name of this toothpaste?
I don't even know, though. I didn't even get to, you know.
Is somebody that's in the circle, man?
Man, in the circle. Well, you know, it's somebody, you know what I'm saying, that is
it ain't nobody in the circle.
You know, it's a friend, you know.
It ain't no friend. Yeah, no, we don't know who it is.
I mean, it's all good to sell products and whatnot, but it's like we get out of hand, you know what I'm saying?
So who we supposed to come on player then?
We come on player to do, with the one-stop shop on the black power. You know, it's just.
I don't even understand how he can even bring it up. Like, what was y'all talking about, toothpaste? Or did you say, like,
it's stuff like you come in, it's like, you know, look, man, I got these socks, man. You got to get these different socks, player. You know, black man got different feet than the white man. White man ain't got the same feet as black man got, you know what I'm saying? It's just, you know, stuff like that, man. You know what I'm saying? You almost said you got these toenail clippers from Zimbabwe, player. You know what I'm saying?
Your toenails a little bit thicker than a white man.
Yeah,
man. If that toothpaste said Colgate, well, I'm a trip the hell out.
Yeah, it'd be the same toothpaste. Here,
they call the nigger gate.
Oh,
that's ridiculous, man. Yo, man.
Come on, player.
Come on.
Hustle, man.
Come on, Black Power Homeboy.
Black Power Homeboy Hustle, man.
Jedi, bring up the video, man, of your boy.
Your boy.
This is our boy.
Marvino.
This is our boy. We love him to death. Marvino, look at this.
I can't even see it. Like, oh, it's baseball. This one, oh yeah, boy, run! Washington. You see him in there looking cool with that cigarette in his mouth?
Run smoking weed in the dugout.
He wasn't smoking no weed. He wasn't smoking no weed.
That nigga stepped to the side real bad.
And then he tried to hide it.
He wasn't trying to hide, man. He just. That's just cool. That's old school cool that some people don't understand, dog. You know?
He was in the dugout, like behind the camera, but he didn't realize it was another camera far away zooming in on him.
Yeah. He said, oh, the camera off? Oh, okay.
That's because he old school. He don't know about the other camera.
Nah, you all right? Yeah, he old school. He don't know about the other camera. He said, that oh, man. Man, yeah, they tried to rip our boy Ron up.
Yeah,
on
he was
talk radio.
He was standing behind one camera. He thought he was good.
And I don't knock no points out for on that, man. I add more. Cause he was cool. No, he was cool as a fan, man.
Boy, Cocaine Run.
Oh, man.
Is one of the only black folk in the history of black people.
Okay, so what was he doing wrong?
What?
What was he doing wrong?
No, you were playing sports, man.
Right.
So what if you saw somebody at a basketball game smoking a cigarette? Exactly. Exactly. That's funny.
No, because this is baseball. This ain't basketball. Basketball is much faster paced. You know, you got to go. Baseball, it can be a little slow at times, and you know, you got time, especially the manager got time to take a smoke break.
You know the old saying. You get
where there's smoke, there's fire.
Give brother rope. He try to be a cowboy.
Oh man.
So next thing you know, he's gonna be snorting them lines in the corner. You better watch out. Look at here, player. All I'm saying is Ron Washington should probably after the
don't say pack his bag.
Yeah, after the cocaine incident, should not be smoking
a cigarette
in the dugout. That's all I'm saying, player. I was about just chilling on the smoking.
He probably was like, oh, I go ahead and put it out, man. They,
yeah.
Yeah, y'all they tripping.
Y'all tripping. Y'all tripping. Oh, I'll put it out, man. It's all right. I would go smoking anyway, but you know what I'm saying? The game was over with. I thought I'd just smoke, you know what I'm saying? He going to try to explain himself, you know what I'm saying? That's how baseball go, you know what I'm saying? Man, run. Man.
Y'all didn't want he can't eat sunflower seeds. He can't smoke, man. He can't do nothing, man. Damn. He can't do the chicken walk that he be doing. The Ron Washington two-step.
The chicken walk. Boy, I tell you. That Ron Washington.
The strut.
Like I said, I love him to death because he defied the hell out the white man. Doggone that I smoked that cocaine. What you going to do about it?
No, come on,
that's
man.
What he said. What you going to do about it? They didn't do nothing. Yo, the last thing I want to come up with, man, my come on players, the gangster homeless man. Now, this is something I heard from my homeboy, his homegirl on Facebook. They was in Las Vegas, I guess.
Yeah.
Man, homegirl had got something to eat, messed around, sat it down for some reason. I guess she had to fix a shoe. I don't know what happened. Sat the food down. Homeless man came on over, grabbed the food, started eating it.
What? In Las Vegas? Oh, man. She shouldn't have been sitting her food down next to a homeless man. I'm going to come on player her ass. You know what I'm saying?
For real.
Come on, player. You teasing the
nigga. I bet you that won't stand.
You going to sit it down in front of me? No, I'm finna eat your shit.
I bet you that won't stand, baby.
This Las Vegas, you know? Out of towner, you know what I'm saying? I can see you visiting from a mile away, you know?
Yeah.
Come on, man.
What was so funny about it is they actually, I don't have the picture of it, man, but they actually had a picture of this dude sitting down eating the food.
Yeah.
Like, he didn't even try to run away.
No.
He was just sitting on down chilling. That's like, okay.
That's how you know he's hungry. He was ready for the fight. And he didn't swing on it. You didn't go up to him, then.
You know what I'm saying?
He was ready, you know? He was ready. When you hungry, you ready. That's all I can say. When you hungry, you ready, you know. And that's what that dude was, you know what I'm saying?
Damn,
man, shout out to the homeless man.
He said, I got food you that know? Night.
And hopefully he ain't raw with it. He probably got somebody else after that, you know. That's probably like his spot that, you know, that they stepped into, you know. His little hot spot.
That dude said, well, you hungry, you. I ready never thought of that, boy, but you sure as hell is. He didn't give a pretty damn.
Pretty damn.
I'm talking about as soon as she sat it down, he just. She was like, excuse me.
You
wow.
Think, okay, so let me ask you this. If you think he would have asked for it, she would have gave it to him?
What?
Hell no. That's why he just took it.
And that was probably the problem right there. Right. He had probably already asked about three people.
Right.
Excuse me, ma'am, because you got to bother you for a french fry. And they shooed him away, you know. Excuse me, sir, can I get a little piece of lettuce? Get your ass out of here. Shit, by the third dude. So he was like, he was like, damn that, man. As soon as she sat it down, scoochies. I'll take that.
She shouldn't have been sending her down, her food down that close to no homeless person.
Well, she didn't know. I mean,
nobody else. Yeah. Period. I don't sit my food down. And
yeah, I'm pretty sure she wasn't too far from it. You know, you don't expect nobody to, you know.
Because I can just see him running up like, just running up from a long distance and then snatching.
Yeah.
He had to been like right there, you know, to be able to get that, you know.
Yeah, he did. Yeah, well, that on that gangster homeless man note right there. You know, we're gonna go ahead and end it, and that's just the bottom line. Watch out for the homeless man. You know, never want to sit your food
down. Don't sit your food down
too close right there. You know, we want to love and thank everybody for listening to us, man. Seriously, man, we thank y'all to death, man. And the Dark Side Elite, all of our
Glass House,
everybody, all other shows, make sure y'all listen to those, man, on Deep Ellum on there, especially Dark Side Sports Radio. 6 to 8, don't be late on Saturday nights. We love y'all to death, man. Dark Side Sports Radio.
If you only knew the power of the dark side.